गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई सुमित्रा नायक वेलकम यू इन योर मॉरल साइंस क्लास। टुडे वी विल एंजॉय एन इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 3, द फ्रूट ट्रीज। इट इज अ स्टोरी ऑफ अ लिटिल गर्ल सुनीता, हु हैड अ हार्ट ऑफ गोल्ड, ऑलवेज रेडी टू हेल्प अदर्स। वी विल सी हाउ शी शोड एंथुसियाज्म एंड बाय हर विजडम ईज्ड आउट हर फैमिली फ्रॉम अ बिग स्ट्रेस। सो लेट्स बिगिन। Sunita, who lived in a small village near Chennai with her mother and elder brother Vishnu. Sunita always wanted to help her family, come what may. Though she had lost her father some time back, she never gave up or panicked in the face of trouble. The story begins with Sunita's sad and worried mother because she had to pay off the bank loan of rupees 10,000 within a month, which was taken to build their little brick house. Sunita kept thinking hard to find a way out, but 1 month was too short a time to pay off so much money. Their rice harvest was not enough to pay the debt, let alone feed themselves. On the other hand, Sunita's mother wanted Sunita to concentrate on her studies, but Sunita could not see her family starving and losing their house and field. One day, while sitting in her fruit garden, in a deep thought, she had a mango seed, which she sowed it there. Sunita wanted to help her brother on the field and pleaded for the same, but all in vain. Then one day, she hopped onto her brother's bicycle and pedaled down the bumpy trail that went to the market. There she met an old family friend, Vikram, a vegetable vendor, who was concerned seeing Sunita's grim face. While expressing his inability to help Sunita, he reminded her of Mrs. Shankar, a rich lady who at times in the past had shown her interest in taking their fruit trees on lease, but Sunita's father had denied. This way, a month passed away, and it was the day when the bank manager was to come and take away everything they owned. Sunita couldn't see her teary-eyed mother and her sweating brother at the crops with sighs. Suddenly, it seemed as if a light bulb had lit in Sunita's head. She raced towards Vishnu's bicycle, jumped on it and pedaled with all her might to Mrs. Shankar's house. Sunita offered Mrs. Shankar to mortgage the fruit trees for the next 5 years for rupees 10,000, to which Mrs. Shankar agreed readily. Sunita told her that the fruit trees were hers, as her father had made a will on her name. Mrs. Shankar assured her that she will soon reach her house to hand over the money. Sunita was like on the ninth cloud. She happily raced to her bike and zoomed down the road. But alas, a goat knocked into her, and there Sunita fell off the road and down the hill towards the river and was knocked unconscious. Sunita awoke and realized that she was in a hospital. She saw her mother, whom she apologized for taking the bike against her wishes. Mother patted her head and cracked the good news that their house was permanently theirs now. Sunita was overwhelmed with joy and expressed her gratitude to Mrs. Shankar, who had saved her and had even paid for her hospitalization. For the next few couple of days, Sunita sat around the house resting. Sitting in the garden, she notices a tall green plant, which a few days back was just a mango seed, freshly sparkling with morning dew. Sunita then murmured to herself, "Just like the new green shoot, our life too seems to have sprung the first spring of hope." Their family was a happy family now. The message that the story conveys is that be positive, wisdom and hard work leads to success. Remember students, when fate hands us a lemon, let's try to make a lemonade. That's all for the day. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.